Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding An Equal Music, A Beautiful Society, written by Ananya Vajpayee. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for sociology and public administration optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to have a clarity on certain important contours about caste. Now the first contour about caste is the strength of caste, and secondly we need to understand the process of annihilation of caste. And then we need to understand about the role of the visionaries in society. Role of visionaries in the society. Now let us understand this concept of caste. Now this concept of caste, it acquires a lot of legitimacy in Indian setup. Now why it has so much of legitimacy? Now it has so much of legitimacy because this concept of caste has a religious denominator underneath it. The religious denominator of Hinduism, the religious denominator of Chaturvarna system, which divides the society into four parts: the Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Shudras. Now as per Chaturvarna system, every caste has a defined role that it must be playing. Now as per every caste, they have a defined way of living life. Every caste has a defined culture, be that the material aspect or be that the non-material aspect. Every type of occupation that exists in society, it has been tagged with the institution of caste. So everything that a man does in Indian society, it is actually attached with caste. Caste is entrenched in every aspect of man's life. Caste is entrenched in how a person is groomed. Caste is entrenched in the education system of a society. Caste is entrenched in the functions that are performed while a child grows. It's the caste that confers the tag of inferiority and superiority in the society. So caste has been conferred a big role in the society. And this is what is wrong about caste. The institution of caste was basically designed to have order in the society. The caste came into existence in order to define the functions of society. It had a functional role, but we have accorded it the role of legitimizing social disparities. We have accorded it the role of justifying social idiosyncrasies. So we need to actually remove that. Now this is what been talked by B.R. Ambedkar in his Annihilation of Caste essay. B.R. Ambedkar has talked about completely eradicating caste. It is only the eradication of the caste that will lead to the emancipation of the disadvantaged sections. Now, as per this editorial, we have categorized every profession according to caste. Music for the Brahmanas, excreta for the Shudras, fighting prowess for the Kshatriyas, knowledge for the Brahmanas. This is stereotyping. This structurizing is wrong. There is a concept called as structuration. Structuration, what is structuration? Structuration means you tend to adopt certain habits when you keep on repeatedly practicing them. The repeated practice of certain habits, certain practices gets imbibed in your behavior, in your attitude. And this is what is hurting the Indian society. Now let us understand the role of the visionaries in the society, plus also the role of the upper sections of the society, upper caste, and the role of the lower caste. It is the visionaries who can indulge into debate. It is the visionaries who can really deliberate on the topic of caste. It is they who need to come forward. It is the engineers, it is the doctors, it is the writers, it is the actors, it is the playwrights who should coordinate with each other, who should build up a common consensus of how much caste plays a debilitating role. It is this very section of the visionaries who can do away with the negativities attached with this institution of caste. It is these visionaries which can help in the emancipation of the society. Now, along with these visionaries, we have certain other things to do. The first thing, the upper caste, the Brahmanas, they need to undergo this purification, self-purification process. Now, what is the self-purification process? Self-purification process means that they should try to transform their way of thinking. That the society is for all. Society belongs to all. All professions belongs to all. The culture is common. The differentiation, the identities, the stereotypes, they should not be practiced. So this is the process of self-purification. And on the other hand, the people belonging to the lower castes, they should try to assert themselves. They should try to assert their identity. They should try to assert their rights. They should try to assert their freedom. They should try to assert their autonomy. Now, when these both things will happen in some symphony, it will yield good music. And that music will be nothing less than annihilation of caste. Annihilation means killing of caste, destroying of caste, crumbling of caste. And if at all the caste remains, it should only be accorded the role of functionality, the functional differentiation in society. Caste ko aur zyada koi bada role nahi dena chahiye ki socially judgments hai caste se. If a person is belonging to a particular caste, ek social stereotypes jo bane hue wo hatne chahiye ki particular caste ka aadmi aisa hai, particular caste ka aadmi aisa hai. These stereotypes should be done away with. Though you can always attach stereotypes, the functional stereotypes. So you need to actually shrink the scope of caste in the society. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact us at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, in order to avail the information with the classes, please visit brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.